If any of you only have 15 minutes to present, after your presentation, you'll have a seat and the commission will ask you questions. Let me start now.
Okay, well, good afternoon, professors. Today I'm going to present my research study, which is called What Are the Motivations Students Have to Learn English in an ESD Course? It needs to be mentioned that this title belongs also to the research question of a study. First of all, it is necessary to promote the context in which this research study was carried out. During the second term of 2016, I was assigned to my practical experience in adult education in Santo Tomas University. The course assigned was a basic English 2 that possessed an ESD methodology. It was the only course inside the university with this type of methodology when teaching English. And it was focused to the public relations programs, which consisted of a class of 26 students, which participated in a regular basis during the class. That's why this question arose. So what are the students' motivations to learn English in an ESD course? In order to answer these questions, several objectives were stated. The general objective is to understand what are the main factors that motivate students to learn English in a new university ESD course. And to achieve this objective, three different specific objectives were stated as well. To identify the students' needs and interests, to identify the internal factors of motivation, and to identify the external factors of motivation. Also, some assumptions arose during this, the process of observations that were inside the classroom, which were that the assumptions of the students were going to be aware at the end of the study of the usefulness of their learning process, of the outcomes, and their own motivations to learn. So now I'm going to explain the theoretical framework, because inside the study there are some keywords that need to be understood. The first concept is motivation. Motivation is defined by Dorney and Ushela in 2011 as what moves a person to make certain choices, to engage in action. This concept, this definition fits this, the purpose of this study, because we want to understand why the students want to learn English, or what motivates them to learn English in the classroom. Inside motivation, there are different factors, which are the ones that we want to identify during the study. Internal factors are defined by William and Burden in 1997 as all the things that are inherently within a person who is learning. So all the cognitive processes the student possess to learn. And the external factors are defined by Agnew in 2014 as every extra situation and model from the outside that the person is influenced by. Also, we need to understand the definition of English for specific purpose, considering that is the methodology that is assigned to this class, and that is the one that is being developed. Raman in 2015 defined ESP as all courses without developed, considering the student's needs and interests, and also purpose of assessment when learning the target language. This means that the objectives of the class, the tasks that they're going to be performing, and the outcomes they have are all aligned into one specific purpose. And we need to understand what another learner is, considering that their mind works different to the other type of learners, like children or teens. And Rogers defines another learner as someone who possesses previous experiences in different classes, which will determine how they will react to a specific topics or situation. And Erickson, in 1982, which was revised in Fleming in 2004, defined adult learner as someone who is not dependent on anybody else anymore, but is an independent being who has set and reached his own goals. Also, in order to carry out the study, a methodological framework was designed. First, this study possessed an interpretive paradigm, because it aims to understand a specific situation in a specific context. In this case, the student's motivation in an ESD class. And the approach of this study is qualitative because it seeks to explore and understand the student's motivations inside the classroom to learn English. The design is an ethnography because the participants of the study are all a group of students who belong and live together in the same context in a regular basis. divided into five different steps. First, the observation process. Then, the application of different materials, which were evaluated in order to be edited and finally applied to the students to avoid the halo effect and the researchers' judgments in the materials. The analysis process, and a triangulation process, and the inferences that finally were born to see if we were able to answer the research question. Well, as I said before, different materials were created in order to develop the study. First, field notes, which corresponded to the observation process, which was the first step of the procedure. These field notes were carried out once a week, along five different weeks. And with also a student's focus group which consisted of four different questions which were evaluated and explored by different experts in order to edit it and achieve the specific objectives of the study. And a teacher's interview in order to perceive his view of the student's learning process. And the data analysis technique that were decided to carry out to get to the results were a categorizing process that was taken from a design that Thomas did in 2009. And it was to analyze the field notes and the students' focus group. This categorization process was in order to identify a specific categories or themes that were that had common aspects in their responses with what the researchers were viewed during the observation process observed. And the open coding was applied to the teacher's interview because Flick stated that the open coding was the specific process and the most appropriate to separate the data into specific categories. And finally, a triangulation of information and gathering all the data that were already analyzed in order to get the inferences, and it was separated in a different matrix with a new specific code and a new specific category. In the findings, the results that were gathered during this exhaustive process of analysis was that there were different external factors which were in a major quantity than the internal factors. First, the teacher's influence on the students was really important to learn the language. And at the same time, the collaborative work of their peers. So they find constant support in order to speak the target language and develop their own ideas. And in addition, the ESP methodology was also an external factor that was really important for the students because they felt constantly that they were studying something to achieve a goal in their professional future, which resulted also in another external factor that was the topic selected to perform the tasks. Most of them were focused on fashion and restaurant reviews and tourism. And as public relations students, they felt they were useful for the peers. These external factors derived into internal factors because each of them had an internal process on the students, a cognitive, social, or affective, depending on the topics they were talking about. When they were talking with the teacher influence made this cognitive process for the students in order to make them realize that they needed the content they were learning. And affecting in the terms of the collaborative work they were having, because the students supported each other and felt comfortable inside the classroom. The contribution these studies possessed is in an academic field. Most studies about motivation are general or specific about types of motivation inside the classroom. This one focused mostly on the factor that students have to learn, the factors that motivate the students. And of course, there were some limitations during the process. That was that the results of the studies are not generalizing, because as this class is an ESP class, the topics and the process was focused only on the public relations students. So the results are not the same for example, medicine students and the public relations students. And the most important limitation was the time constraints. A qualitative research takes time and organization. And in this case, the researcher couldn't manage the time of the teachers or the students, but her own time. And that was a little bit of a problem of organization. Finally, the metacognitive analysis. Concerning the internship experience, I found different strengths, weaknesses, and challenges. When talking about internship experience, we're talking about the practicum experiences that I had in the last 2 years. And I realized that one of my strengths is that I get involved in the student's life. I commit to the process. So I try to understand their needs, their interests, and constantly support them if they need help in everything to make them feel they are inside a comfortable environment. Well, one of the weaknesses, I think is the most important, is that I still fight the need of giving instructions in a simpler way. I realize that during the classes, I tend to use complex vocabulary or not enough body language in order to make them understand. And sometimes they end up doing something completely different, or they just don't do it because they don't understand what to do. Which is also one of my greatest challenges. Learn how to use simpler words to explain what they have to do. And as Ericsson said, in 1982, children and adults and teens had something in common. They learn by watching when they can hear. And in concerning the research study, one of my strengths is that I always want to go beyond what I'm what I'm learning. But there goes my weakness, is that I'm not really good organizing my time. So very often I'm not able to organize the time and to actually study anything I wanted to study, which is also one of my greatest challenges. Because as Pez in 1988 explained, time organization is essential when you think you don't have the necessary time to do everything you want in your